It's a kind of concentration of energy in a different area, really, which is like, so for instance, if you're on stage, your energy is much bigger and over a wider space. And if you're on camera, on film, and you're in close-up, your energy is concentrated through your eyes. And then if you're in a vocal booth, as Doug said, you're working all that imagination and energy to come through one point, which is here, because that's the communication point. The odd one about that is doing motion capture stuff. I don't know, you know, how many is where motion capture is almost a perfect hybrid of theater and film, because you're in close up all the time, but you're physically alive all the time, which is a very rare thing on film, because on film you're either being shot from a distance, a mid shot, or a close up. On motion capture, you're alive in that area the whole time. And that's quite a discipline to have. And it took me a while to get used to. I likened doing motion capture to being a child in my bedroom when I was a kid and inventing stuff around me. You know, because you, as Doug was saying, we have no outside stimulus when you're doing that. And you have to imagine that. And, you know, I watch my daughter. I used to watch my daughter play in her bedroom, and she'd be imagining all this stuff going on. And I thought, yeah, that's exactly what I have to do when I'm doing the motion capture stuff, to just use that childlike imagination again to bring that game to life. It's quite good, because basically I've got the mentality of a 12-year-old most of the time anyway. So
he's not lying.
Yeah, that's kind of how it works for me. And it's just different disciplines of what we do for a living, really.